Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI radio button control. The Syncfusion.NET MAUI radio button control serves as a selection mechanism for users to pick a single option from a predetermined list of choices. In this video, I will demonstrate how to add Syncfusion's.NET MAUI radio button control to a .NET MAUI project and customize the appearance of the radio button text. I will also show you the two states of the radio button and how to customize the appearance based on those states. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application. Then, give the project name and location. Next, create a project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before I move forward, let me set up the application's environment. Here, I select the Android emulator from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. After selecting the emulator, I'll run the application to show you the default output. The application compiles the default code, so wait for a few seconds. Now, the application's homepage is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate the radio button control into this application. For that, I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI button's NuGet package. So, I first open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI buttons package and select it to install in my project. Once the package is installed, I need to register the handler for the Syncfusion core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. So, I open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then, register the Syncfusion core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. It is necessary to register a trial license key to use the Syncfusion MAUI controls. So, I open the app.xaml CS file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out where to generate the trial license key, click the link in the description below. Next, navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. Remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI buttons namespace. Initialize the radio button control and set the text to radio button. Width request and horizontal options are added to align the radio button. Enclose this radio button within a stack layout and set the vertical options to center and expand. Look here, the control will be displayed on the emulator and you can check the radio button. Now, I will show you how to create a group of radio buttons for selecting payment options. First, remove the existing radio button and set the stack layout vertical options to start. Next, add a label and configure its properties to customize the appearance. Set the text to select payment options and background, font size, font family, font attributes, height request, horizontal text alignment, and vertical text alignment properties. After that, initialize a radio group to group the radio buttons and name it a radio group. Within the group, add 5 radio buttons for the payment gateway, each accompanied by its corresponding text. Check here, 5 radio buttons are displayed, allowing you to select only one option from the group. To programmatically check the rupee radio button in the group, set the isChecked property to true. Now, observe that the rupee option is checked. To customize the color of the radio buttons for checked and unchecked states, add the Content Page Resources tag. Inside this tag, create a new Resource Dictionary tag. Then, add a new style and set its target type to Radio Button. Use the Setter instance, set the Check Color property to an appropriate color value. Similarly, set the color for the unchecked color property. You will notice that the radio button's colors will dynamically change based on their respective states. Now, let me show how to customize the appearance of the button text. Inside the style for the radio button, I set the text color to blue, font size to 16, font family to Arial, and font attributes to bold. Look here, the radio button text appearance is customized. Finally, I will demonstrate how to customize the appearance of radio buttons based on their visual states. Before starting, I removed the checked color, unchecked color, and text color setter instance in the radio button style. To illustrate, create an instance of the visual state groups and add visual state group list. Within the group list, insert a visual state group and name it common states. Then, include a visual state and name it checked. Now, create instances for the setters. Within this, add a new setter instance with its property to background and value to an appropriate color value. Similarly, add a setter for the checked color and text color properties. Next, include an unchecked visual state and set the color for the unchecked color property. Check here, radio button's appearance changes based on their states. In the checked state, the text color changes to white and the background color is applied. In this video, I demonstrated how to create a .NET MAUI application and incorporate a Syncfusion radio button control into it. I showed you how to customize the appearance of the radio button text. I demonstrated the two states of the radio button and customized them based on their state. To learn more about radio button features, check the documentation link provided in the description below. I have also included a link to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.